Hello, Hollywire. This is Lewis Capaldi here. Thank you very much for watching.
Hollywire, what is good? Jana in the studio with Lewis Calamari?
Lewis Calamari. Capaldi.
Capaldi,
but
I know.
I go by both names. It's like Sasha Fierce.
All right, Lewis, we're going to play Hollywords. You're going to spin the wheel. Whatever it lands on.
We talk about it.
That wasn't your best spin,
that
but...
That says heels or sneakers.
It does say that.
I don't know if anyone can imagine me in a pair of heels. Maybe. I tend to stick to sneakers. And these sneakers, which by the way, I was watching a Billie Eilish interview the other week.
Yeah.
And she said that Vans are small energy. I wear exclusively Vans. That's the only type of shoes I wear. So, you're looking at a man with a small
and you're still gonna wear the Vans.
Oh, I'll wear them. Somebody's gotta have small energy. Do you know what I mean?
Okay, cool. Spin again. Right. Okay.
Go to Starbucks drink. I only really started drinking coffee last year, I think. Because I'm a child, I didn't drink coffee.
You didn't know how magical it was.
But then I got really into it, like at the end of last year, and I was cappuccinos, Americanos, one of the other drinks ending with an O, and then I used to drink caffeine and get panic attacks. So like I couldn't have a coffee without rattling and within like 5 minutes. So I stopped drinking caffeine, but now I drink just a decaf iced Americano, purely for the taste, because I'm bloody hard as nails.
Yeah. Okay, spin again. EDC or Coachella?
What's EDC? I've heard
it's electronic dance music.
Oh, cool. Never heard of EDC, so I'm going to go with Coachella. I like that people dress up and do like they've always got like nice outfits on, and
yeah.
I mean, I think music happens as well, but I'm not really sure. Yeah, I like it. It seems like it'd be nice to go in the desert and hang about. But like Jesus, for those who don't know, Jesus spent 40 days and 40 nights in the wilderness in the Bible, in which he resisted various temptations from the devil. And I guess if I went to Coachella, it'd be a very similar vibe. I would try and resist temptations and just enjoy some music.
What would you wear to Coachella? I feel like you would come up with something really creative and funny.
I would probably wear just a loincloth.
And Vans?
And Vans, yeah.
Loincloth and Vans.
It'd be a very small loincloth, I tell you that. It would not cover much space at all. Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to get into your music, of course, but you're like a walking meme.
Okay, I've got a memeable face.
Your captions are so funny.
Oh, thank you.
How do you come up with this stuff? Is it like a secret?
Yeah, we have like a room of writers. We all get together and we pitch, they all pitch ideas. And I just say, I'll take that one. It's kind of like SNL, but it hasn't been on the TV for 40 years and it's not as funny.
And you have this thing for sunglasses on your Instagram, all different types of shades. How do you choose which is the most grammable pair of sunglasses?
I get given a lot of them at thingies. The first person that ever gave me them, I was in Philadelphia, and it was a Scottish girl who said, these are called clout goggles. And I didn't know what...
Wait, sorry, clout?
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 Yes.
Clout.
Language barrier.
Clout, got it.
I didn't know what that was at the time, but now I'm all about the clout. Trademark that, because that's going to be on a t-shirt.
Speaking of t-shirts and merch, you are also quite the merch person.
Yep.
Sold a lot of it. And you have the Lou roll.
Yeah, the Lou roll.
What's the craziest merch that you wanna come up with? Aside from the Lou roll, because that's pretty crazy. But.
So the Lou roll is, for people who don't know, I mean, imagine it's like toilet paper with my face on it. And that's basically because I talk a lot about going to the bathroom. And last night, American plumbing isn't as great. Well, as from my experience, it's not
Wait,
as good as-
Wait, really?
As well, I mean, maybe the hole in the toilet's just a lot smaller. No one notified my bills to the change. But, so I went to the bathroom last night and I flushed. It was like middle of the night. I went back to bed, woke up this morning, came through, and it was definitely still there. And I had to go to CVS this morning. Because why would the hotel charges $5 for a Voss water in your room, but they don't have a plunger, which I think was quite strange, or a toilet brush.
That's very true.
So I ventured over to CVS and I asked the lady, do you have a plunger? And she said, yes, we do have a plunger. And I had to degradingly walk back across, I think, Hollywood Boulevard and walk past all the people. There were people getting like pictures down the thing. And with like—
with a plunger in your hand?
Yeah, well, and I'm definitely in the back of some of those pictures with my plunger. So I guess, and then I went home and I went back to my room and I really worked on it for a couple of minutes. It didn't go down as easy as I thought it was gonna go down, I'll tell you that. It was a lot of elbow grease and a lot of, just really had to get in it. And yeah, eventually the blockage was cleared, but I would like to create maybe some like plungers. Basically, that was a whole convoluted
personally,
way of me.
Personally, yeah, that's a great idea. Like, I get that.
Look, sometimes some poos are bigger than others. That's exactly what I'm saying. And they get locked up in there. And you're gonna need a plunger, but use the plunger, which is spelled P-L-E-W.
Plunger.
And those are my new merch idea for you. You asked me the question and I've answered it. Plungers.
That was the best. That was the most elaborate answer to a question I've ever had in an interview. Well, and I loved every second of it.
I was just giving you a little peek into life as a pop star.
Okay. On to the music, onto your song. I think like the best breakup anthem.
I mean, if Adele decides to release something, I'm but yeah, thank you very much. I really appreciate it.
I don't think so, Lewis.
Well, people ask me what type of music I make. You say, do you know who Adele is? And they say, yeah. And I say, well, imagine her, except she's a guy and she's a lot less talented. And that's me. Thank you very much. I mean, it's a sad song, but I'm very glad that you like it. And I hope that people listen to it a lot more because I would like it to become a big hit and make lots of money.
Yes. Would you ever collaborate with Adele? Would you and Adele ever do like a sad song together?
She has nothing to gain from collaborating with me, whereas I have everything to gain from collaborating with Adele. So if she's watching this, Adele, I'll work with you. Stop phoning me. I'll do it. But I'd love to collaborate with Adele. I think Sia would be pretty good as well.
She's got a lovely
voice. But I'd love to work with anyone and everyone. Literally, times are hard, the work is drying up, I'm very desperate.
What about album coming soon?
Yeah, it's called Divinely Uninspired to a Hellish Extent, which I agree is the most stupid album title anyone's ever come up with. And I apologize in advance to anyone going to buy it. I apologize for the ridiculous album title. And I'm sorry to the label, because it cannot be an easy thing to try and market an album with such a stupid title.
But, I mean,
they seem to be doing a good job, so thanks to them.
I'm so excited. I think the album name like stands out.
Thank you.
I do.
Yeah,
you know?
People like.
I'm gonna be like, what is this? If I didn't know.
Well, there you go. But I think I just wanted something that was a bit different, and I didn't want it to be like, you know, Standing at the Foot of the Seabed or something by Lewis Capaldi. Do you know what I mean? Which is quite. And I wanted to call it something that was a bit weird, and that maybe people would look at it and go, well, that's quite interesting. I mean, then they listen to the music and they go, this is not interesting at all. But if we load them in with the album title, that's all that matters. But I like it, but it's definitely weird.
Oh my gosh. Okay, well, everyone needs a Lewis Capaldi in their lives.
Thank you very
that's
much.
That's what I know after this interview.
Yeah, okay, nice one. Yeah, thank you.
Make sure you guys check out all his music, go get his new album when it comes out, see him on tour, all the good stuff. And for more, keep it right here on Hollywire.